I'm nervous it's gonna stop.
What's going on? What did I miss?
You miss Becky's shit being stupid per usual. She goes, I feel like it's gonna cut off, but before she could say cut off, it
cut off. What?
I feel like it's gonna click.
We're having Shane charge it or
dog, I don't
know. Wait, what? Where does that come in, Bo?
This happened the last, remember the last episode? We would just be talking and Becky would be going off on a tangent and then it would just cut off. That idea was perfect. I just wish I knew how it ended. Well, that was a great intro. Welcome, everyone. This is episode 7 of No Wahala. It's been a very interesting week for all of us.
It's only going to get more interesting, though.
Oh, my God. This is the last week we have with Obama. In fact, this is by the time this episode posts, Trump will be...
You would all have chains on you. We'll all find a farming sect. You know, sharecroppers, you know, everything lit, though, you know.
How are sharecroppers lit?
It's, you know, it's one of those things, as the Nigerian in me, we always got to find a positive in every and any situation. So, you know, we'll find it.
Wow. Yo, you guys remember when they were still running and somebody made that meme, like, if Trump wins the election, I want the part of the plantation with the most shade.
Facts.
Oh, facts. Gosh.
Facts. Like, these are things you got to call out now. You know, you got to put that positive in there because we know everything is going to hell. Just every single thing. Live tweet, Papi. Yo, imagine, I was just saying this early on, if you saw it on Twitter. Like, you remember when Obama killed Bin Laden?
Fact, and everybody forgot about it because they were like, oh, he's still Obama.
Nah, this is how crazy it was. Like, it happened so quick. Like, all we had was just news that it's over. I feel like Trump would live tweet it. Like, all right, my forces are now around. You guys said I couldn't do it. Wrong. Fake news. All that. Yeah. And then Bin Laden will find one tunnel and just disappear. But no.
Yeah, go ahead. Yo, ladies and gentlemen, it's the G's. It's the G's, baby.
It's the G's, baby. You want to the G's, honey. Tune into the G's. Come make a knock you the G's, baby.
So, speaking of fake news, did you hear about the legislative aide from Annapolis that got fired because the New York Times put a story up about a fake Clinton story he wrote, and it was because it was shared so many times, it was shared like 6 million times or whatever, that was what kicked off all of the fake news that happened for the rest of the campaign. So when they found out that he was behind it, his boss fired him, and he's like, oh, I was just trying to prove that news can't be really trusted, and that I hope that I can get a job where I can, you know, he was like, I hope I can get a position through this that like helps make our news organization stronger, and that's all I really wanted to do by doing this. I'm like, bro, you really derailed an entire election by putting
you really just killed the country.
But like, I'm surprised you're not in jail already. Like, I can't believe you had the nerve to be like, oh, we're just trying to help our country and, you know, show the world that fake news is really a thing and anybody can be swayed by fake news. Bro, you should be in jail.
Congratulations.
You played yourself.
Hey, bruv, like, are you proud? Nah, but it's so insane. But I don't even know who's to, like, what finger to point, because I was reading Joe Biden. They wrote an article about him, and he was like, yo, I feel bad because I shouldn't have focused so much on Trump. I should have done more speaking well on Hillary. And, you know, it's just everybody taking blame for it because we never really saw it going this far, you know?
You know what the mistake was? Honestly, what I believe the mistake was?
What?
I they should have just let my nigga Bernie Sanders.
Why you gotta be a nigga though?
She gave him the pass. She gave him the pass. He's gonna be the one mixing the punch in her cookout.
Word. Yo, Bernie gonna do the electric slide with all of us. Don't play.
Like. I hate all of you.
You can't see Bernie just standing by the punch, just telling you how good it is with mad passion.
Oh, Bernie's just gonna keep making sure his Bengay is active. He's not even.
Yeah, he's gonna make all that bangs as well. It's a lot though. Shout out to all the cassette Michelles in the world, by the way.
Dog, no.
Yeah, no, all of you are shameful people. I'm sorry.
She dashes and the cassette Michelles of the world canceled.
Yes. There is so many of them. Like, yo, by the time this is heard, like, it's going to be crazy. It's really going to be a whole different world. And Cassette Michelle is building her bridge to old Orange Head over there, saying she's going to help us. Thank you so much, Cassette Michelle. Like, oh, my God.
She's already burnt her bridge.
Bro, they don't come back home. Just stay in D.C. Trump got mad room in the White House since his family's in New York. I just was by Fifth Ave, and it's a whole bunch of security checkpoints. So there's room. Oh, my God. You can't go through there anyway. It's just cops all over because he got his family, and I guess they want to protect where he stays. But
like, I really was waiting for someone to come out and be like,
I really still think Obama going to do one more thing. Like, I'm still holding hope.
I'm not saying anything that's going to potentially hinder any travel to African nations should I need to take vacation.
Well, so, you have multiple passports, so you can find a way. That's the one good thing about being African, or just being an immigrant. You have multiple passports. You got to find your way. If you got to go through Cuba, whatever it is.
I don't know what you're talking about. Yeah, that's another thing. I want to go to Cuba before that potentially isn't an option anymore.
I want to, but there's just been too many pictures taken in Cuba. I feel like Cuba has been like solid. Too many Americans have been to Cuba in the span of 1 month.
You know what's about to happen.
What? It's like you're gonna go to Cuba. There's no more old cars. Everybody got G wagon. Like it's Lagos or something. So
how they get the G wagons to Cuba?
The amount of Americans in there, I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure. Like, they have Pokemon rest stops all over Cuba or something. Like, I'm tired of the amount of people going to Cuba. Maybe I'm A'ing.
All the best Pokemon are.
They're all there.
All the legendary Pokemon.
Mewtwo is just selling in a cigar shop. Yes.
Mewtwo's like, yo, I'm for everybody. He's gonna get here. I'm for everybody, though.
Even you yourself, you find blue eyes. Just cruise.
I've always wanted blue eyes.
You know, not Exodia. You want blue eyes. Oh, man. We're gonna make this too nerdy.
Oh, man. Yeah. Shout out to everybody that's African that knows what Pokemon is. Shout out to everybody that was allowed to do Pokemon. Because I know in my house.
Yeah.
We had to sneak. We weren't allowed to play Pokemon because my mom didn't want us playing with monsters. She thought they were evil.
I've met some people who thought they were evil.
You can't play Pokemon. You know what Pokemon means? Pocket Monster. We will not see.
No, it's so funny. Jesus' name. When I was growing up, I grew up in Africa, so.
Africa. Don't be those Africans that say Africa. Say your country. Say your country.
Well, I say that because I literally moved from country to country. So I just.
Okay.
I grew up like in South Africa, Botswana, Zambia, like everywhere.
I would believe you. On that.
She was a little girl from what's that movie with Idris Elba?
What?
Oh, the Netflix movie. I can't remember.
Yeah, what is it called? Frig.
I only know the one where he was a creepy guy. I don't know how.
Idris Elba, Netflix.
That's literally what I just searched for you. Beast of No Nation. Got you.
Beast of No Nation. Perfect. We should have known that.
Shame on us. It's just, I think Trump is already wiping our memory. We don't know it.
Wow. Okay.
Rebecca was Stryker from Beast of No Nation.
Wow. Rebecca, tell your story. Don't let him silence you.
Oh, yeah, finish.
Okay, so yeah, no, they used to put like little Pokemon cards that you could like put together or trade off, and like the potato chips and the Simba chips. You guys remember Simba chips? I don't know if you know those, but
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Okay, I want to see Lion King now, but carry on.
No, Simba chips, they're like the best potato chips in Africa. You guys are sleeping. But they used to
no. Nigerian Pringles tastes better, I think. Yes, like,
who said Pringles? Oh my gosh.
We don't call them Pringles. We call them Pringles. Pringles. Pringles.
One, as soon as you open it, boys are just flying. In hostel. In hostel, I used to have Pringles in my locker.
I definitely have to bring Simba chips when I come back. Like,
yeah, bring them. Afi Simba, Afi Mufasa, all of that. Just bring it.
We'll raise it in the air like Simba if it's good.
Yo, you will, because it will be that good. You guys are okay.
I'm not saying it's not going
to
be good.
You're trying to sell us Simba chips, and then you tell us it's whack. Like, what are you doing? What are you talking about?
It's not whack. It's good.
Alright, we'll see. Yeah,
bring the damn chips, man. What are you talking about?
Pringles is a high standard to be. Like Pringles, like we know Pringles. This is how good Pringles is. We know, we've heard rumors of the owner being like a devil worshipper, and we still don't care. We still don't care, because as long as this thing tastes good, bruh, we don't care.
Wow. Y'all hear about El Chapo?
No.
He's headed to New York, right?
Yo, how is that even? Yo, what?
I don't know what's happening. Are they gonna like?
I El Chapo to United States when Trump is beefing with Mexico right now? There's mad solos out here.
I think it's gonna be one of two things. I have the answers for you guys. Either he donated to Trump's camp, you know, and this is a thing, or he's gonna be the new star in Power. The real, you know, what's the guy called from Power? El Jefe. He's gonna be the new Jefe.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, like Chapo could be the new Jefe. Like, he doesn't have to act it. I could see that. That's my two reasons why the man would be in New York. Nothing else makes sense.
True.
That's crazy that they shipped him to New York of all places.
That's the only thing that I don't understand. Like, there's got to be something deeper happening.
Yeah, like, it's... I know he escapes everywhere, but it's like so far from Mexico. I don't even know. I don't know where he's going to head up. But imagine El Chapo escaped and just shows up in your house.
Dog, it would be like, it would be like Batman, dog. It'd be like,
what would you do?
I would leave. What do you mean?
I would be so happy.
Well, yeah, I keep asking what I would do. I'll be in another country. By the time you ask me what I would do,
No. Becky, what would you do if Chapo ended up in your house?
Honestly, I'd pour him a drink. I'd try to sit down with him. No, for real. And I'd really like pick his brain. Like, yo, my nigga, you've been escaping all this time. You managed to escape New York. How? Please tell me how. Like,
I would be so down for whatever it is he's about to do. Like, yo, no question. He's like, yo, the car's coming in 5 minutes. We out. I'm packing my toothbrush. I'm packing my hairbrush, and we out. Because the man is balling out of control.
Word.
Every time I see Narcos, I'm like, why don't I know this man? Like, why didn't this man dig a ditch? Yeah, like, go ahead.
Remember the taxi driver? Like, just for driving him. Or, damn, did you watch season 2 of Narcos?
Of course. Yes. I didn't like it as much as I did season 1.
Season 1 was just, like, excellence, but yeah.
Yeah, season 2? No, there's an episode in season 2 where he needs a taxi driver because he needs to get into the trunk, and he has the girl sit in the back. Yo, the amount of cash he dropped that girl just for doing that? That's crazy.
This is what I need. There are miracles God is sending your way, and then they're talking about, I'm out. What? El Chapo is here, like, he's gonna have somebody drop a bag at your doorstep.
Dog, I don't want any bags to be dropped on my doorstep that I mean,
Lord, please. Anything, I'm in church. I'm in church on Sunday praying for bags on my doorstep. Hashtag bags on my doorstep.
If you open that bag, Nkwa wasn't there.
Money? It's El Chapo. What is he gonna get? El Chapo is going. Do I care?
Wow.
I do not care. I need people to know this. I was just talking to my mom about this. My mom was like, no, I'm going to tell you this. I was talking. Let's talk about this real quick. I was telling my mom, right? I was asking about my cousin and how we all think he does, you know, like he's a scammer. Mm. He's in England.
Who boys?
So my mom's like, hey, I'm like, why? Let the man make his money. She's like, what? What? If he goes to jail, he goes to jail. That's on him. Like, whatever it is you do in life, you should always think about the consequences. If you're like, yo, this is the worst case scenario and I can deal with it, go for it. As long as you're not killing nobody or selling drugs that kill people, go for it, man. Like, there's so many.
He's not doing that.
He's a scammers do card fraud. And everybody's money in their bank is insured. If your money's in your bank, they steal your money, what do? You call your bank, bro, I didn't buy a pool. I live in an apartment and where am I putting a pool?
I like that.
Bro, I know that I've heard of people that go to clubs, have their party in clubs, and call the bank and be like, yo, I ain't buy no bottles. And they get their money back. And that's that. Because your money's insured. So, yo, I will never scam because I can't be in tight places for a long time. And I just sometimes I like to walk, you know, so I can't be in nobody's jail because I can't just take a stroll, you know. So I can't scam. Like, if I was okay with being in jail, I'd be scamming. I'd have different belts.
For real.
I would wear two belts a day. Like, oh my God, I might end up in somebody's Snapchat. Let me not look with the same belt. That's mad foolish. So, but unfortunately, I don't want to be in anybody's jail.
Sadly,
so,
I have a scamming story. You know that? Sadly.
Oh, no, I'm logging off. Hi, man. I'm not going down. I've heard about this implications.
You don't show anyone on, that you're implicating. You're not implicating anyone.
I'm not. Yo, why are you playing? If you let me finish, I can get to what I'm trying to say.
Do not finish.
Do not start. Do not finish.
Scamming. I got scammed.
Oh, okay. All right, you can tell that story.
Go on.
Now you want to hear my story?
Not really, but I'm not as scared.
I'm not afraid.
No. You know when you're naive, it's kind of like the old time 419s. Remember when the Nigerian people would be like, oh,
I don't remember Nigerians ever doing 419. I don't know what you're talking about.
I don't even know what that means. What is
419? What is that?
Emails about how somebody's person passed away and they just need this much money, $20 million. I'd be like, where are you getting $20 million from?
Never heard of that.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, no. But one time, I was so naive, man. I was in college. I still am right now. But this is like my freshman year when I was OD broke. So, this guy. Nah, you know how you see scammers? They stay balling on Instagram. Like, they're always, like, posting cash. I'm like, yo, how's this making
sense? You're supposed to do.
I know, but, like, I just came here. I moved here, I was sheltered, and then that was my first time being on my own. So when I saw that, he's just like, oh yeah, all you gotta do is give me your card number, this, that. I'm like, oh, that's it? That's lit. Mm-hmm. I remember this kid, I look at my bank account, I'm like, what the heck is going on? He's like, this guy's texting me like, yo, call your bank. I'm like, this doesn't even feel right anymore. I literally walked into Chase, like, I need a new bank card. My card got stolen. I don't know what's going on right now. Like, I didn't want to do it anymore.
Right. Now, but seriously, everyone's money's insured, so I'm not pro scammer. I'm just pro get your money. Get your money whichever way and know their consequences too. So if you're in jail, well, me, I would never put no free somebody, whatever, unless it's reason. I'm not wearing nobody's face on a shirt.
Damn, so just, if I got locked up, you wouldn't do that for me?
What did you do? Are you guilty or not guilty?
As a great meme/vine once quoted, I don't know who created it or originated, but if you rap about getting or selling drugs a week ago,
just a week,
when the week is over,
it's over.
If you get locked up,
is it your fault?
It's your fault.
It's my fault.
I mean, is it my fault?
No, it's not, sir.
Is it your fault?
It's not, sir.
Honestly, I feel like if I were to ever get locked up, it would be for harassing a cop, because that's usually what happens.
Oh, yeah, so you going down. You're going down. I'm going to come visit.
Damn, it's crazy, Bawo. You wouldn't say free my nigga Becky. You
would... No. I would not. I would do keep nonsense. I would ask the cop, has she learned a lesson yet? They'd be like, no. I'm like, all right, cool. All right, I'm going to just say hi. I'm going to say hi real quick. Keep the door open.
Wow. Bawo, you want to come and sit down with me? You just say hi.
Nah, keep the door open. Keep the door open. You good? All right, keep your head up. Keep
your head up, Becky. That's crazy.
Like, we tried to calm her down in English, but she wouldn't respond.
This is my issue. I'm 6'3", right? I want, and I'm a black man. I want very little static where things will be confused for me grabbing something or raising my hand. Like, I be moving really slow and chill after 7 p.m. I don't want any issues. I'm dark skinned. Somebody confused one thing for another thing. I'm going to brush my hair. Somebody shooting at me. Like, these are things I don't need. So I be trying to stay out of every single trouble. So as soon as I arrest you, I'll go to my pastor. We'll hold hands. The prisoners will be staying in a circle. In a circle. Oh, Becky. You know,
the power of God.
And then when we finish, I'll be like, wow. So me, I don't want any trouble. You know,
that's
crazy. So at least we got you in our, keeping
bro, like correct prayer, like Becky, I'm talking about like very strong prayers,
night
like
vigil,
head shattering prayers. No, I gotta be at work in the morning, not night vigils. I don't want to lie to the girl. She go to jail, she gonna be like, yeah, but I'll pray for me right now. I was sleeping. I have a bad back. I need 8 hours of sleep. All my back tightens up. It's crazy.
Wow, it's a wrap. It's a wrap. I can't.
No, why are you fighting police? Yeah. Why? No, that's my brother.
I fight police on behalf of all of us.
No, not me. For the rest of them, don't fight police.
Did you not just say that you're 6'3", you move with caution? That's why
I don't need to fight anybody.
The police don't control that. The police is listening to somebody else. Now, if you're going to fight the commissioner, then we can't talk. You don't fight a soldier to end the war. Soldier doesn't control the war. So as you fight the police, as they cuff you, I'll be like, wow, that's crazy. Again, drive to pastor. I have it all taken care of. So don't worry, you'll be out. They'll reduce your bail money. We'll afford it.
Yo, so did y'all hear about the Women's March happening? Well, will be tonight when we post it, but...
Yo, yeah, I heard about that. I think it's dope. I just think it's crazy because every single group can march against Trump. It's like, I can't think of a group of people that can't find something in common to march with Trump. There's blacks, they're gays, they're women... There's just being a human being. There's having ears. They're animals. It's just so many groups of people that can band together and be like, yo, this Trump guy is not it. And no,
there's
March.
Cover all of that. It's supposed to cover his like racist and anti-gay and all those comments. Like, that's the purpose of this whole thing. And if Beyonce's supporting it, they're saying that they're expecting anywhere from 100,000 to 200,000 people.
And there's over 150 artists that are going to be there.
That's crazy.
Like Questlove, Rakim, Angelique Kidjo, Samantha Robinson, MC Light. They're expected to perform, all of them.
You think Steve Harvey? Where you think Steve Harvey is going to be?
I don't care about. I don't even know who that is right now, honestly. I used to know who that person is, and then for whatever reason, I've lost.
I haven't known him for a long time. I really don't know why people haven't called onto this man and his scams.
I mean, maybe because he didn't spell it right or something. That's why.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, God even made him mispronounce the winner, and he still didn't catch it.
I really want to go just to see Janelle Monae, honestly. Maxwell's coming too.
Janelle Monae is so big.
Maxwell's supposed to perform as well.
Isn't Solange supposed to perform?
I didn't see her name, but I wouldn't be surprised if she's one of the 150-plus artists.
Talking about performance, like, can we speak on Bocella after this?
Bocella?
I'm very upset.
Bocella?
Is that not... That's not what we agreed on last time when calling it? I guess not.
You didn't pick up when Bawo had said Bocella, you know, the representative of all things blood, but just the blood of Jesus Christ.
Blood of Jesus Christ.
Now, we're not actually blood.
I don't know Big Soldier. Like, the only place I go to is church.
Big Soldier?
Yes.
Did you just call Soldier Boy Big Soldier?
Mr. Draco Malfoy? Yes.
I hate you so much.
That's his name. What does he go as? Isn't it a Big Soldier?
Dog, honestly, I call him Crank Dad or whatever. I don't know what to call him, honestly.
Not his Big Soldier. The man went to the hood, had both hands in the air.
DeAndre Way or whatever his name is.
Big Soldier. Draco Malfoy.
Jeez, horse.
Give the man his credit. But yeah,
they were moving mad people from the lineup. They took off Sonny Ade too, which is annoying.
I don't know who to boo. Like, if I boo loud enough, you think they're going to hear me?
Wait, so what happened with that? Did you ever ask?
I'm asking the circle. I'm getting more information. I promise by the next show, we'll have super, super details.
Wait. When did you guys find out about this?
This was two days ago.
They published that information on the 12th. That was like Monday, Tuesday.
Yeah, I found out late. I think Twitter put me on to the atrocity. But I'm doing Cali this, next month? So we'll still be there.
Yeah, we'll probably be at the same time.
Yeah, we'll see. But it's a shame. It's a shame. Shame on all of them. And I don't know. Somehow, I think it has to do with Trump. I'm just going to keep blaming that man for everything.
Sonny was probably like, don't let them take my visa, I will.
No, imagine. All the band members are like, okay, leave me alone. I'm not going.
I'm a legend. They can't lock me in this place, so I don't matter. No, for God forbid.
Wait, but going back to Trump real quick, I'm so sorry, Bao.
Yeah,
but
get
out. No, it's because you heard that they advised him to dance with Caitlyn Jenner.
I read that somewhere. But do you know how bad you have to be doing where that's your power move?
No, because here's the thing, right? Caitlyn Jenner, like, even she had tweeted that all Republicans need help understanding the LGBT, whatever, community, and I'm here to help. So I feel like that's their power move. Like, okay, if Trump dances with Caitlyn Jenner, he understands the gay community, he understands LGBT, like, whatever.
Honestly, Bobo, or Caitlyn Jenner, Bobo, you're to me. Honestly,
no, I really, like, this is my thing. Trump is not winning them over. Like, you have Mike Pence, who believes he has a way to fix them. And then you would basically just lose some of your supporters, all those super anti-gay people on Trump's side. So I really don't see it happening. I don't see how it could win. I don't know what Trump can do to actually win over the LGBT community. So
how many other communities? Like, you still have the Black community to win over. Like, it's more than just LGBT that you're doing.
Which I don't think he's gonna win over. I don't see how anybody can be like, okay, there's this one thing Trump can do to help me out. I'm telling you, Trump could like literally deliver my child and I'll still walk out and be like, yo.
God forbid that Trump will deliver your child.
Exactly. Like, yo, please. Like, the man could cut the umbilical cord with his hair and I will still
Was it her that said that she feels like Trump is being bullied?
Who said that?
I think it was Zoe Saldana. I can't pronounce her name, Saldana.
Oh, yeah. She said something too.
It was her.
Like, everybody has just been showing their yash. Like, it's crazy. Like, y'all really should just sidestep this. Like, if you want to do it, just DM Trump. Like, yeah, I rocks with you. I can't really say it out loud because, you know. But they have been showing their yash for a long time. And I'm like, Kanye did it. What's it called? Ray Lewis, who's another schmuck, he did it. Who else has done it?
I'm not pro Trump, but in a sense, she's kind of right. Like, everybody's bashing Trump from left to right, man.
Let me shut up there.
No, but okay, I get you saying everybody's bashing Trump. I get that, right? So what do we do when somebody's doing bad? Because now, Trump starts off as the non-politically correct candidate, right? I'm say how I feel, blah, 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 and boom. So now when we're telling you you're bugging, now we're bullying Trump. When Obama won, Trump could not stop talking about Obama.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like, let's not forget that this was just 8 years. This was really the man starting off trying to win the country, and all this one was talking about is he wasn't born yet. I understand if you know that. He didn't even know that, but his whole thing was to just come at him and destroy the fact that he's the legitimate president. So how are we, like, now you're getting something similar and we're bugging? You want to play victim? that's why I'm like, all these people are just, they're cornballs. So we said, as beautiful as she is,
if you actually do tie all of that in, like the whole thing with Trump and racism, you know, it kind of starts to make sense. Like, a black president wins and you start to say, oh, he wasn't born here. Interesting.
Because they couldn't believe that America made such a decision.
Like, yeah, I couldn't find the dirt on him.
It's unfathomable to them.
He was Muslim. He's pastor is crazy, but yet he's still Muslim. It was every single thing. But now they were bringing your ish out, and mind you, there's actual receipts to prove that you're insane. Like, there's so many things to prove that you're insane. And then your candidates that you have for offer, like on your cabinet, are bugging. I don't know if you guys have been keeping up with it.
Oh, I have been. He's putting people in position. They don't even know why they're. Like, in the middle of their interview, I actually don't know why I'm here, guys, but I'm going to learn on the fly and figure it out, because...
Like, how scary is that? Like, so, for someone to say he's being bullied, I really hope he out, like, stood up for Barack when this was happening, which I'd be shocked if they did.
No.
Like, how do you complain about a bully being put in his place?
I actually watched a CNN, it was like a panel that they had going on where a Republican supporter was basically saying that, the Republicans never bashed Obama when he was getting into office, and they never said anything to delegitimize his presidency. And the interviewer was like, are you nuts? Like, that was all you guys did. You basically...
Wait, is this the one with Anderson Cooper? The with, what's her name? Kellyanne something? Yo, she sounded... No, but eventually she sounded so stupid, because I remember she kept bringing up, who is it? BuzzFeed. She kept bringing up BuzzFeed and all of that.
No, it wasn't this one. I know the one you're talking about. It wasn't this one. It was another one. It was a black dude. I forgot his name. It was him, another Republican Trump supporter, and then I guess he was, not that she was neutral, but she was more leaning on the side of the black dude. Like, Republicans definitely tried to delegitimize Obama's presidency when he came into office, and the Republican guy was like, no, we didn't. There's no way we would have stooped down to that level. And Democrats are trying to delegitimize this because they lost and they're sad about it. And instead of them to be, you know, Americans and, you know, accept that this is what was happening, and the Americans voted for change, and the black dude and the other dude and the other lady are like, what are you talking about, bro? Were you sleeping 8 years ago? Like, what are you doing? Like, everything was the opposite of what you're saying right now.
Every single thing, bro. They found so many ways to drop the man's, like, respect. But he won it, and he, like, throughout 8 years, he was graceful with it. So, and Trump, you say one thing about him, and he got 140 for you. He got 140 characters waiting for you. So, it's two different things. I don't think he's being
Twitter fingers.
Bro, you can't wait. His Twitter's going to be so lit, and he's going to upset. It's going to be so lit because we're just going to be laughing at it.
Nah, but his daughter said that he's going to tone it down.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Speaking of tone it down, did you see Jimmy Kimmel ask people if they knew the difference? Well, he basically trolled random people on the street to see if they knew the difference between Obamacare and the Affordable Care Act.
Bruh. I will give the Republicans that. That's probably their biggest thing, where they really got people to think it's two different things.
Dog, they literally convinced all of their supporters that Obamacare and the Affordable Care Act were two different things. And because they did that, they actually screwed themselves into voting to repeal Obamacare and also voting to repeal the Affordable Care Act. Because guess what? It's the same thing.
I saw some post on Facebook like, are you home or are you at your house?
I'm going to put a link to it in the bottom, but Jimmy Kimmel literally went in the street and was asking random people, so do you think Obamacare is better or do you think the ACA is better? And one by one, oh, I hate Obamacare. I don't like anything that Obama is doing with that. But the ACA is fine. I like ACA. ACA helps.
His name triggers.
Afford stuff. That's it. And he proved that literally all those people that are supporting the president-elect are literally buffoons. Literally idiots. It was amazing to watch. Because it's not like we are saying you're an idiot. It's you are publicly making it clear to the world that you're just uninformed and ignorant. and
not that bright.
Those are people that voted. Those are our great American citizens that voted.
Representatives of us. Like, it's such a beautiful thing now. Some guy was on Twitter, like, showing. He basically was asking people what they're excited about Trump, like people who voted for Trump. And it's so. Somebody said he would bring godliness back to the White House.
Oh, God.
Someone says he's never seen a politician who so precisely understands the issues of jobs and immigration.
Dog, he's
a man who gets things done. He doesn't talk, he acts. Someone said she likes that his ego is so large that he wants to be the best, so he'll work towards being the best.
Yeah, so he can grab.
Someone says truly a man of his word. Somebody says, I admire that Trump is always willing to admit when he was wrong.
That's a joke.
Someone says he loves Trump's honesty. Someone said, the whole fate and honesty and him being honest. Like where are you guys seeing this?
Okay, the honesty, I see that. The rest of it, though?
I don't see the honesty either. I really don't.
It's coming from a very dishonest place.
The man is not. We still don't know what he paid in taxes. The man doesn't pay taxes. Like there's nothing honest about that. It's just.
I think they mean honesty in terms of like his
blunt.
He's blunt because I know the issue. Like also why Hillary didn't win is that people felt like they couldn't trust her. Like she's not being honest. One moment she's all for the White House. The next thing she's hiding emails in her basement.
I don't trust Hillary. I still don't trust Hillary. I don't think Hillary is a trustworthy person. But there's a big difference between just saying what's in your head, or saying like just yelling. Because I don't think it's what's in his head. Because I know the man knows what he's doing. So I don't think it's being honest. It's just like yelling and just saying things repeatedly or attacking somebody and being honest. And I feel like a lot of people have just misconstrued what's really happening. It's going to be the most interesting 4 years ever. Like, I just feel like the world is watching the greatest reality show and we're in it. And we were never like, actually, like, how did we get, we're in a movie we don't want to be a part of. And we're, and being black, the black person always dies first. So we're all just and people like, how am I a part of this? And
speaking of movies we don't want to be a part of, did y'all hear about Yams Day yesterday?
Oh, I heard about it. Couldn't make it.
It was definitely a movie.
Okay.
I will say that. But in retrospect, I could have dealt without being a part of it.
Ooh.
Yams Day. That aren't aware of Yams Day. Yams Day is an amazing event that was put together by the members of the ASAP Mob Collective to remember ASAP Yams, who was a member that passed away 2 years ago due to things that I don't want to bring up on this podcast. But he was an amazing influence to the music industry. He was well loved by the community, hip hop community especially. Amazing guy. So Yams Day is a concert that the ASAP Mob puts together to remember him. The problem that happened at Yams Day, and that this is a recurring issue, this is the second iteration of Yams Day, the organization surrounding the event is a little, oh no, not a little, it's very disorganized. The security is abysmal. The guest list situation is crazy. Like, people are fighting left and right to get on the guest list. A lot of people that think they're on the guest list are not important enough to even be on a guest list, and they're just holding the process up for people that are actually in the industry and need to be there. And then, outside of all that stuff, the actual event itself was very disorganized. Many of the artists that were supposed to show up to perform didn't even show up. Kendrick did pop through, which was awesome. Playboi Carti popped through, cool. Danny Brown popped through, awesome. Weeknd popped through, great. Weeknd's performance, guys, I honestly don't think I will go to another live Weeknd performance.
I could have told you that. Well, I don't know. I don't think he's that good a performer.
Not a good performer.
He makes dope-ass songs.
The entire night, he was off-key. His entire performance of Low Life, he was not on the right key at all.
Maybe it was just a bad night. I love him.
He's a great writer.
Amazing writer.
Beautiful songs, and his studio engineer is like... should get paid whatever he deserves, whatever he's getting paid. But I'm telling you, the man live, because it's just keys that you didn't like a bar. That's, you shouldn't be doing that.
Some people are just not good live, and
there are a few people that aren't good live, and it's sad. But you know, you're human.
Kendrick killed it though.
Kendrick, every Kendrick performance I've seen has been dope. So I'm not going to. But The Weeknd, seriously, it's just like, why? Like, it's just not his strength. But yeah. I really don't think there are very few people touching his pen, because the man is dead nice with it. Mm-hmm. But, and I remember there was this one time where people were comparing him to Mike because he does the falsetto thing. Mm-hmm. But then you see him perform, and it's just like, bro, I know you're not a dancer, but no.
Also, you guys know who William Onyebo is?
I heard that name earlier.
He's like a very classic Nigerian funk musician. He kind of like pioneered the funk and disco, or he kind of pioneered the African EDM movement back in the 70s.
Okay.
And, he passed away this week, yeah. But he's been covered by like The Fader, and Vice did a documentary about his life. Super influential Nigerian musician. If you've never heard of him, Google him. William Onyebo, rest in peace. Definitely somebody that y'all should be aware of if you're fans of Fela and Afrobeat and Afrobeats and its new iteration. You should definitely be aware of that guy. So rest in peace to that guy.
This week was pretty. I feel like everybody's just been antsy for this week.
Yeah.
Obama's speech was crazy popping. And shout out to Joe Biden. I don't think everybody loves Joe Biden, but I don't know if he gets as much attention. Shout out to Joe Biden.
The legend himself.
Yeah, he's like the, he's, Joe Biden is the man. Like, I feel like I would miss Joe Biden a little more than Obama, because I just feel like Joe Biden doesn't bite his tongue. Like, there's nothing written about Joe Biden. He just feels it and says it. Like, if we're talking about somebody being honest, Joe Biden is somebody that just be like, yeah, F it, I don't give two shits about it. So, let me wipe my tear for Mr. Biden. And did you hear the, what's the name of the gorilla that passed? That everyone keeps talking about, Harambe?
Harambe, yes.
Harambe's grandmother died.
Oh, really? Yeah. Wait, so Harambe died before his... Damn.
Right? Like, it just makes the story even sadder. Like, but that's, I think that's the first, second, because, you know, like, second big death that happened. But Harambe's grandmother, rest in peace.
Rest R.I.P. Mama Harambe.
Grandmama Harambe.
Grandma Harambe. I mean, technically, in our culture, we say mama.
Yes, true. This is true. That was my big story of the week. I don't think anything is bigger than grandmama.
We even have a goat of the week.
Chrisette Michelle. I feel like it should be Chrisette Michelle. And the damn speech she wrote, like, oh my god, like, Chrisette, I really love her music, and she's just. And I thought she was cute, you know what I mean? She had a little thing going. And I don't know what she does.
Definitely quiet for her.
It's so sad. It bothers me. And did you read her letter?
Nope. And I don't want
to. She really tried to. She said she's building a bridge.
You should build it and jump off of it. I don't care.
Bro. Like, people are just shaming.
Do the damn thing and jump off it. I don't care.
People are shaming themselves.
It wouldn't be the first time. Just Twitter, you know that.
That's it.
Twitter still exists, and so does Instagram. You shame will not end.
That's definitely my goat of the week.
One single shame they don't have.
Not one. Steve Harvey was the last. Steve Harvey and Chrisette Michelle. Every single person.
I don't know who those people are.
Every single person that's just rocking with this whole inauguration and this administration that
I don't know what that is either.
That thinks that the man is gonna help us, or that the man is interested in helping us. Where the history, like, when somebody's, how old is he? 50, 60 years old, however old he is, like, doing what the hell he's been doing his whole life. You now feel your little 10-minute conversation is gonna change things for us, or you want us to believe. Cause I know they don't believe it either. Like, you want us to believe that this is what's going to change things, then more power to you. And for the dummies that believe that they're doing it for our sake, like, God bless you too.
That's what, did you see how Trump's office basically said that they don't consider Kanye West to be an acceptable American?
What?
I saw that.
After Kanye, like, went out of his way to try to meet with Trump to discuss black issues, and Trump is like, we don't consider Kanye to be an acceptable American. Like, how embarrassing is that?
But that's his man. He's my good friend. That's what he was saying, and he got him gassed.
He got him gassed just to make him look stupid in the end, which is why, and people have said, like, yo, be careful aligning yourself with people. Even to have simple conversations, some of them will use it against you. You know, now Kanye looks really, really crazy because he made it seem like him and Trump were on, you know, were eye to eye on certain things, and now Trump is just like, nah, he's not even real, dog.
He's not. Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Can I switch goats?
Switch. Who's the biggest goat?
I'm sorry. I just realized the biggest goat, like, a lot of people are going to be like, oh my God. I have so many goats because I was actually thinking about it this week.
I have so many goats.
Yo, bro, I'm ready. I'm ready for, like, what's it called? The next Muslim holiday. I can just dash it. Everybody gets a goat. Good. Like, I'm going to be, they're going to come to me and I'm going to give every household a goat. Yeah, I roast it. Fight. Every which way. Like, goats. I'm the goats one. But, first one, this is like, everyone's going to be like, oh my God. MLK the third.
Oh yes.
Very, 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 very. I get so sad how big a goat he is. And you know, the man's older than me, clearly, and he's the son of MLK the second. And it's, you know, it's a beautiful thing. But fams, like, why? Why do you have to be as such? Why can't you keep the legend? Just keep the torch burning. Like, what's up with you? But it's so sad, bro. It's really sad. I know there's pressure on you, like, you know, your pops is this guy, but just shy away. Don't come in acting a fool. Like, why are you running with Trump? The man is coming at you. You're like civil leaders and you're talking about, oh, bow tie said things. I'm like, wait a minute, what? And then I remember this is the same guy that wanted to sell his pops' Bible and the Nobel Peace Prize that he's
got. Because he doesn't care. He just wants money.
Fams. And, yo, and he just... Okay, let me not even talk about
it. He's Kanye's cousin. Okay.
I'm not going to talk. And then...
MLK the third is Kanye's cousin with a laptop.
Bro. Basically. That's basically, it. Like, he's trying to get paid.
He's just trying to get that bread.
He probably has, like, MLK's black book and wants to sell it, like, on my podcast.
Probably sold it, which is why you never heard about it.
See? That, and then the next go, which I'll speak about right now, is whoever is involved with remaking or making the documentary, movie, whatever, about Flint's water issue. Like, you're making a movie about a situation that's happening. Still, like, what's your end? What happens at the end of the movie? What do you, like, how thirsty are you to get paid? Like, whatever it is you're doing, go donate that shit.
You know what?
I agree with you.
To help people understand what really, I don't know.
Invest the money that you want to use to make the fucking documentary and invest that money to figuring out who needs to go to jail. How about you do that?
I feel tension.
Nah, it's sad. Like, yo, there are people really out here without clean water. And obviously, we're going about our days because everybody has their drama. But to now have it in your mind and not be helping them directly, that's just whack.
I agree. I'm still sticking with,
Chrisette,
though, dog. Because we don't know who to blame for the Flint thing. And what was the other one?
MLK.
MLK. I mean, he's been a goat for years, so I don't think there's anything to do.
It's not new.
This is a complete sidetrack, though.
What's up?
My goat is Selena Gomez. I don't know if you guys saw the whole thing with The Weeknd.
I don't even know who she is, dog.
I know
she has the most followers on Instagram. I will tell you that.
And I know she's been on Justin Bieber, right? Or something.
Remember Wizards of Waverly Place on Disney?
No,
I don't remember Wizards of Wabalinde.
So what are we talking about?
We don't watch movies.
Why would I have wizards in my African home?
Like, okay, do you know what kind of home we come from? We can't watch Witcher.
Oh, wow. Here, remember the girl, Justin Bieber's girlfriend?
I know what you're talking about.
I just don't know who you're talking about.
Well, her. I think she's a goat because, listen, she has a history of taking her friends' boyfriends after they break
she's
up.
She's lit.
No, like, really, she did it with Nick Jonas after Demi Lovato broke up with him. Mm-hmm. She did it with Taylor Lautner after Taylor Swift broke up with him. Mm-hmm. And then, no, it's crazy. And then The Weeknd, like, Bella Hadid, they hadn't even broken up for that long, and you guys were friends, and you're caught making out with the guy?
She knows what she wants. Like, she hears a good story and goes after it. There's nothing wrong with that. That's what she wants.
You're a goat. You're a goat. They're all your friends.
And she's like, and he did what? He took you out? And he, oh my God. Yo, but every time I think about her, I remember how I read somewhere that Bieber rented out the entire Staples Theater to play a movie, and they just watched it just on the big screen.
That must be nice.
Bieber is goat.
Yeah, Bieber Valley. In a good way. Shout out to Lil Bieber. Lil Bieber, aka Bieber Valley, aka Bizzle. You know, shout out to him.
The one and only.
You know, save Bieber at all costs. You gotta protect Bieber at all costs. You know, the world has tried to come against that kid.
That post about Obama leaving, huh?
Say that again?
20 minutes ago, you're posting about Obama leaving. I see, huh? You're sad.
We're all sad, bro.
It's the depressing part. Like, the man, you know, far from perfect, but he was just too smooth with it.
What I tell you, she's Striker from Beast of No Nation.
She don't appreciate good things.
Pause. Can I put something up? This is a complete sidetrack too. I'm on Instagram right now. No, these are all complete sidetracks, and like, I don't know about you guys' Instagram feeds, but my Instagram feeds has had way too much ass eaten for my
What's going on here?
I don't know what that is. We don't talk about
this. I don't like this.
You can speak to the people. I'm just going
to
be here.
This needs to stop. It's never going to catch on.
Call me when this conversation's over.
I keep seeing it on my timeline, and it's just like, yo, I got to unfollow these people.
You got to unfollow niggas. I don't know who you're following that's posting shit like that.
This is so nasty. It's never going to catch on. For everybody that's listening, it's never going to catch on. Stop it.
So that's what they do in Greece. That's the culture you are bringing to Africa.
So these are the gyros. Pause, rewind.
That's what they mean.
This is the hero, the high
road. Pause, rewind, stop, eject.
Wahala is not a place for judgment.
You better keep the ejection. No, I don't want it.
No, Wahala is not a place for judgment. All right? So come as you are. We just don't have to. We don't have to change our lifestyle because, you know, you're into the wild side.
Whoa. I just said it needs to stop. Why? Listen.
But you brought it up. You know what I mean? I didn't think it started for it to be stopped. But you know what? The people you follow obviously have a lifestyle. And
I follow mad live entertainment companies, and it's just, this is happening in clubs.
Because they're all getting their butt ate. That's the gross.
You know what? I'm about to tag y'all in it.
No, you're not. I'll report you as spam. I have friends that will, and we'll have your Instagram gone in 10 minutes.
Okay, I will hit up all my people on Instagram. Like, look, anybody that has this name, just prevent her from creating.
Nah, report as spam. I give everybody $1. Screenshot as you report her as spam.
Bad PayPal.
Yo, everywhere. Comment your email. And like this comment once the dollar hits you.
Funny.
Nah, nobody's okay. Doing that, please. I just had me some nice everybody away doing stew. I'm in a good place. Yeah, I'm really calm and chill. You know, I didn't even get to finish drinking my water because the show started. But I'll go back and I'll make that water. I'll make it into tea.
All right, so let's wrap it up then. What's everybody's track of the week?
Do you want me to go first? Who's going first?
Y'all could figure it out.
Save the best for last. I want to go last.
Okay. Mine is Situationship by Odumsi.
Ooh.
Okay.
That's a nice one.
Yeah, I mean, I be doing my research out here.
So for people that don't know what we're doing, so give us the background.
Okay, so this is an up-and-comer. I hate calling anyone up-and-comer because I feel like it speaks low to their grind. But, you know, he's not as known yet. But he has that alt sound to it that's not regular Ninja Afrobeats. You know, the vibe is there. So I think his future is bright, you know. He just has to catch the people that are rocking with his lane. Shout out to Odunsi. Oh, did we big up Migos for shooting a video in Ninja?
Yeah, we did that.
Okay, so shout out to them. But yeah, Odunsi, big ups. Situationship featuring AYLO. Mash, mush, all that.
Why? Becky wants to go last. Of course she wants to go last.
Of course.
Such a doo-doo head.
Wow, we've been tagged. All right, so I want you all to say bye to
no,
Becky.
You really did not.
It's been a pleasure. Like, she ain't even send it. She ain't even send it to us.
Oh, my God.
We're in the history. Like, she could have sent it.
Why would you do that? Look at what you
said. We're the only comments. Can you delete me of this?
Why are you tagging us in this?
I'm going to delete it.
No, you're not. We've already seen it.
You can't unsee this, bruv.
No, they're putting their fingers in the back.
What's going on with people's children? Like, somebody took this child to dedication in church.
Let me tell you why. See, this is why I'm in Jersey. Where is this at? Where is this happening?
I don't even know.
No. Bawo, read the description. Where is this
Saturday? Oh, this is definitely Elizabeth, Jersey.
This is why we don't go to New Jersey.
What's he to do in Jersey?
Keep your nasty shit over there. All right.
Yeah. Don't cross that water with this. What is that? Like, why would you talk? I beg, please.
I'm flagging this so bad right now.
the page, the comment, everything.
Report. It's inappropriate as far.
The comment isn't even there anymore.
Hashtag get Becky out of IG.
The report section is actually mad funny. Let's see what. Choose a reason for reporting.
No, report section is lit. I had to report somebody's page today. I'm not even going to tell you why.
Dog, your self-injury, eating disorders, cutting and promoting suicide.
All of the above.
Harassment or bullying, sale or promotion of drugs, nudity or photography, violence or harm, hate speech or symbols. I just don't like it.
I hate speech. It's a hate speech against decency. That's what that is.
Oh, that's crazy.
I want to put self-injury because you're promoting suicide.
I've been throwing up since.
You're promoting suicide. Cutting and eating disorders.
I've lost 7 pounds, bro.
That's disgusting. Wow.
Now we know what Becky's into.
Wow.
No, that's on my timeline. Damn. I reported two. You know, earlier there was a much nastier one on my timeline.
What's going on with your timeline, B? You need to change your life. I'm going to send you some pages to follow.
Please do, because the funny thing is,
Franklin?
I'm an African person. An African person had posted it. I was just like, nah, I gotta report this because I can't.
I'm going to send you some pages. Kirk Franklin would be the beginning, and we'll just go from there.
It's okay. I follow TD Jakes.
You what?
I follow TD Jakes.
Oh, you follow TD Jakes. I really... So sooner or later, what's crazy...
Becky's track of the week is banned for that shit, bro.
Yo, what's crazy about her following TD Jakes is that she's going to be scrolling one day. You're going to get a nice little inspiration thing. And then you... Right beneath that picture is going to be somebody eating somebody's time. Like, you have to... You got to figure yourself out. You just have to.
I don't know what's
cut off officially.
What you need, Becky, is a one-on-one with yourself.
That's crazy that I get blamed for this. That's crazy.
You brought it into our world.
I tagged you into it because I came across it on my timeline. Like I used to have a social media manager that just stopped 4 days ago, literally, and she would like follow and unfollow people for me. So it's just now that I'm finding out the pages that she follows.
I know Tunde and I need her back, dog. Tunde and I, all we do is just follow people of the Lord. That's all
parishioners.
Parishioners and people of the Lord. That's it. And we just what's the last post you have on your timeline today? Could you just share? Just open your Instagram. What do you see?
It's just the last snowstorm we had. You know, we took very nice pictures. A few parishioners took some nice shots and we
I'm hitting refresh right now and guess what's on mine?
What?
A scripture. A scripture.
My most recent one is R.H. Sin, my favorite, or Sign, whatever, my favorite writer. And it says, better single than taken for granted. I'm a bitter black woman.
Wow.
See what she's... If it's not asking, it's about men being scum or something. These are things that you're into. I feel like you need a one-on-one with yourself.
That's crazy, Bawo. That's crazy. Y'all are rude for throwing me under the bus like that for some Okay, can we just go to track of the week? Is it my turn?
Yeah. Anyway, since Becky decided to derail the entire show the track I've decided to make my track of the week is actually very special because this record was recorded at a time where a lot of people weren't really rocking with this artist for whatever reason. You know, a lot of people are biased. And, you know, since this track was recorded, the artist has gained a lot of more fans because of his activity on the timeline and off the timeline. And people are recognizing that he's actually a really, really dope artist, aside from all the bias, from all the trolls and stuff online. So the artist that I'm referring to right now is Wale. And I don't know if it's live everywhere yet, but by the time the show drops, the song will be live on iTunes and everything. But the song that I will be dropping, it might be a premiere on the show. It's called Running Back, featuring Lil Wayne. And yeah, this is supposed to be off of the album coming out on Shine. So here is Running Back. Boom. So that was Running Back by Wale featuring Lil Wayne. It's fire. I like it. A lot of people like it. Boom, boom, boom. So
Shout out to Wale and his beautiful daughter.
Shout out to the fine girl.
Fine girl. Hashtag fine girl.
Viola Moon Oluwakemi.
Give them. Right. Becky, no pressure, but you know, you brought the Nyash Muncher. This song has to be all flames. It has to be all flames.
Like you just like poop.
Has to be hotter than.
It is flames. It is flames.
Oh my gosh.
Okay. So this dropped, I believe, yesterday.
Oh.
Was it yesterday? Yeah, it was yesterday. Have you guys heard the remix for My Woman, My Everything?
Yes.
By who?
It's Patarenku, Michelle Montano, Busy Signal, Wendy
Cole. I have not heard it, but
we need 17 drops. It's all flames.
It's super flames. Like
put us on.
Hey, you guys gotta hear it, man. Just hear, listen to this.
Boom. So here's a remix to My Woman, My Everything, Patarenku and Company. Boom. Mad flex bombs. Boom, there you have it.
Pew, pew. More pew. Add additional
pew. That was a great addition.
Exactly. Yes. Michelle definitely killed that intro. That shit was fire.
This is true. This is true. The whole Afrobeats, soca, reggae mix, all that. It's crazy how like it's about to be.
And now, about what it's about to be, shout out to Techno.
Okay.
Techno just signed to Columbia. I believe it was a $3-4 million deal.
Give them.
You know, shout outs to Chief Obi. Shout outs to Paul. There was a lot of people that were there for the signing. So shout outs to that whole team at Columbia for recognizing some talent from the motherland.
Yes.
And I wish the best to Techno. Hope he continues to put out the fire that other Afrobeat artists that are also signed to major labels in the United States have been kind of slacking on doing. So shout outs to Techno.
Shout outs to Techno. Wiz and Drake got a song coming out.
It leaked. Yeah.
What do you guys think about that song?
It leaked. It's not done yet. So I don't want to comment on it until it's out. But it sounds pretty good. I mean, the version that did leak is pretty good, but it's not as good as the final version.
I just don't see Drake and Wiz making a bad song. I just feel like he's not going to pull another Daddy O. And shout out to Bills for remixing Daddy O. I was going to speak about that. I don't know if you got a chance to listen to it. It was really cool.
Was he in the original, or was that something the video he just put together?
He just put the video together.
People were sending it to me like, oh, he was in the original.
No. He wasn't, not that I know. He definitely wasn't, because he was in America when that video was shot. He wasn't in the original. We bashed. Well, you guys bashed, because, you know, I said good things.
You guys.
Like two both they are under the bus. Wheezy Baba, Twilight Baba, anything for the boys.
Whiskey comes out. Bawa's there, Dabala in full.
Wheezy Baba, stop boy teams.
Do you guys have some story today on Instagram?
Wow. What?
You watched some story on Instagram today?
Who's your Yoruba demon hat?
Yeah, they're
here. Oh, shout out to my boy that makes the hat. I'm sure he got it to Wiz. That was pretty dope to see. It's always dope when you see your people's stuff, like, you know, make it out there. I just hope, you know, it translates to sell. But big ups to Ade, who got the hat to Wiz, I guess, when he was out there. Yeah. And big ups to Bills for remixing Daddy-O, because the original is still basura. It's still very much wet garbage.
I like Bills, man.
Yeah, Bills is so... I don't know if you've seen him perform. Oh, my God.
He did that song... what's that song he did a few years ago that was really
Standard? Good?
No, not that one. Oh, was it Standard? There was another one.
That one, the Standard.
Yes, that one, but there was another one. Whatever. And you know what I'm talking about. It came out on the same time.
Damn, I'm trying to remember. Can't right now. We probably
he performed it at Olamide's concert.
Oh, ooh, damn. I gotta help him. They got remix the Bills in Nigeria doing this thing right now. The remix was popping. So no pressure to Wiz, but your last song was trash, so let's see what you got.
Wizzy boy making trash. Yeah.
Wow, Starboy teams.
Well, that's crazy when you realize both Starboys have been putting out Abysmal.
Oh, wow. What are we saying?
We're blaming all this on Rebecca, by the way.
Yeah, wow. Rebecca.
But we went from blaming Trump to blaming me. That's crazy.
Trump didn't show me an ass eating video on Instagram.
Yeah. Let's talk about Trump as not being as bad as Rebecca.
Yo, Becky's the new alt right.
No, Becky has Trumped. Like, what?
Becky's so alt right, she's alt left.
Yo, bro. Wow.
He was too liberal there, dog.
Yo, we can see, like, if we were in Alaska, we could see Becky from Alaska. That's how it is.
She's with Sarah Palin. Just
people might not be able to catch that, but that's how it is. From my backyard in Alaska.
Alaska way.
Crazy.
I can see Becky just, you know, just doing Russian things. I don't know. finding models in hotel and just doing... No. So we're saying Becky was with Trump. Like, Becky was Trump's connecting.
Becky's the one that linked El Chapo and Trump together.
Becky told El Chapo, like, come through. We don't put you in the Trump suite.
Got you. Just come to WizKids concert. We got you.
Yo, Becky got Chapo and Trump suite right now. That's what we're saying. So, wow, Becky, that's crazy. Oh, and shout out to Gambia, who has two presidents right now.
They basically are they the first country ever to have two presidents?
It's an African country. I'm not gonna say this is the first time. African men don't like to let things go. Like, to get an African man's daughter, you gotta put cash up. Like, think about that. It's just crazy.
Who said I'm gonna be a president for a billion years? Like,
yo, bro. Like, fams, they voted. You're not it no more. Like,
I'm sorry, I don't care, like, who voted.
This is like the prom queen coming from with college credits, coming back to high school to come do the royal wave. Like, no, fam, you don't go here no more.
I'm keeping this crown up to college.
Man, they had to give the new president his title in a different country.
That's nuts,
though. They're like, your homie's bugging. We're going to take you elsewhere. You the man now, though. Like, you can't be in your country. No, shout out to Gambia. You guys have it figured out. You guys are good. Like, Nigeria, you bugging, but Gambia, you have it figured out.
I don't hear anything about Gambia doing MMM, so Gambia still got it, dog. Gambia still got
shout
it.
Shout out to Ghana, copy and paste. You guys are good.
Oh, man.
That was good. You know, Ghana is doing their thing.
Somebody said that their president still looked like it was from a high school theater set.
Oh, wow.
Speaking of Ghana.
Oh, no. Becky about to kill them.
She about to go in. She about to go in, dog.
I'd like to say...
I'm not going in.
You about to go in.
She goes in.
I'm not going in. But did you guys hear about the beef with Mr. Easy?
Oh, yeah.
Nigeria was roasting this guy as if he was like O.J. Simpson or something. Like,
give them. give them OJ references.
No.
I think what he said came from that place.
Yes, yeah. It came from the place.
He said it in a way that it was triggering to most Nigerians. Yeah. Like, I'm proud.
I spoke to people about this because I was like dumbfounded by the fact that it's such a big deal.
Exactly.
And I spoke to people about it, and I think his the trigger word was the understated, I think was the word he used, can be under, there was a word he used, that last word he used, I think bugged people out. And you know, there's this thing where Nigeria and Ghana just can't see eye to eye. It's just, and it's not because Ghanaian men are typically short, it's just like we in Ghana don't see eye to eye.
You're right.
They like defend, Nigerians are defensive about Ghanaians.
About anything.
It's just one of those things. And then when he tried to give credit, it's like, bro, don't even go there. You're one of us. And I didn't think it was a big deal. But I didn't think it was a big deal either.
But we actually study music, so we understand why.
Yeah, like, I see where you're coming from. Like, yeah. I'm talking to my aunt who's done mad music events and booked a bunch of artists. And she's like a college graduate. She's well educated. And she was offended by it. And I'm here trying to have this conversation. I have this rule where it's like, when I talk to you and I realize none of us are budging, I just be like, yeah, I see what you're saying, and I keep it moving. So I had to hit my own aunt with it. But she was really bothered by it. And I was like, what's the big deal? She goes, no, this guy, by supporting him, you know, like, they really felt like they brought Easy in, like, where Ghana wasn't showing him as much love and started showing him love. That's after.
Bullshit. Nigeria was not trying to claim Easy, though, for a minute.
No. They've been claiming Easy since they found out he was
I always thought Easy was Nigerian.
Nigeria was not trying to claim Easy.
No, this is the thing. I think he blew because of the Nigerian claim. I personally felt like he's dope regardless if he's going to make it. But I think it happened faster because obviously Wiz signed him. And then you have things. I think there was an award show where you can't win if you're not 100% Ghanaian, that he was snubbed out of and things like that. But Nigeria claimed him and he just won a Nigerian, I think the Headies or something like that.
Yeah.
He just won. So Nigerians feel like, yo, you're really coming, you're getting too comfortable. And that's one of those things where it's like you are talking to your pops and y'all making jokes and you say some crazy shit and now he's like, all right, now you can't eat at the dinner table with me. You gotta go back. You'll be chilling with your pops like, pops, you crazy. Mom ain't the only woman you've been with, and now you're like,
ah, so I'm growing wings.
I shouldn't. Yeah, basically, that's what it is. I feel like they were so offended. Like, they felt like, yo, we brought you in, and now you're just, you're taking our secrets and running with it. So it was great. It really was just like they overdid it. Like, everybody was talking about it. Facebook, and you know, Facebook don't get things till like a week later, but Facebook was on it. Like, all my Nigerian cousins were talking about Easy.
Yeah, I heard that. That's news that I saw, and I was like, these niggas are just triggered.
This is ugly. Yeah, it's really ugly. Do you feel like he was bugging Becky, or you think he was right?
No, he wasn't bugging. He had, first of all, he's entitled to that. He's entitled to say what he thinks. Or
Becky's hurt. I know you.
I'm not hurt. No, I am an Easy fan, but all I'm saying is, like, Easy's entitled to that opinion. Like, I don't think he should be crucified or, like, you guys, I don't know, were you reading the comments under his pictures?
No.
I don't want to get tagged by butt pictures, that's why.
Yeah.
All right, you guys are wildin', but that's why.
We're wildin'.
You're the one wildin',
but you tagged us in ass-eating videos.
No, that's what I'm saying. Like, people were acting like he's like O.J. Simpson or something. Like, people were dead commenting crazy things because he's promoting his New York show, his Ghana Independence show that's taking place in New York. And people are commenting under that.
By the way, what's happening? Are we going? Who's going?
I'm going. You going?
We're going to that.
We're going? All right, so we'll be
there. Yeah,
let me go and find how much.
Everybody listen, y'all got to come March 11th.
March 11th, we'll be there. I'm going to buy my tickets.
Twitter, Times Square, you know, be there or be square.
I'm going to buy my ticket, though.
Yeah, all the dudes listening, if you've ever asked me where all the African joints are, you don't show
that's, me. That's definitely that where they're going to be.
I don't want to hear it.
All the parishioners.
Do they actually have a competition for the girls? like they could win a date with Mr. Easy like just before the show, and it gives them like free tickets to the show.
Boom, there you have it. So ladies listening to, I don't ever want you to miss second or third place. If I have cousins, you can meet all my cousins at this concert. I don't
want
to hear
whoever, that. I just want whoever doesn't win, like you can put them on to me. I'll take them to church.
It's fine. You know, Bible studies, that was good.
Yeah, these are the things that I really want a woman to be interested in what I'm interested in, and it's church.
You can hand them the word.
Praise
them.
You know what I'm saying? Him. Like we can compare notes on the Bible.
Compare notes.
You know, you get it.
You are stupid.
You get it. Yeah, so Mr. Easy will definitely be there. Shout out to him. I'm excited. He's been through a lot, so he needs all the love. When he comes to New York,
so I'm land of Ghana, the world. Center,
screaming his lyrics right back to him.
You gonna be out there screaming lyrics?
I'm gonna be screaming.
Wow! Wait,
what's the age to enter the show?
I believe it's 18 plus.
Okay,
you'll be there.
Yeah, that's what I didn't want to say.
Oh wow, you guys are disrespectful.
That's set up. She didn't even think about it.
Disrespectful. I see. That's how you come in. You know what? My 25th birthday, both of you, I don't want you there.
It's fine. I don't want you to ask me live. I'm good.
I don't know. What music are y'all playing? What activities are happening? Like, everybody will be doing music with
you. My Neck, My Back by Kia. That's the first song she's putting on.
That's crazy. I'm sorry the two of you are old. Bawo, how old are you?
I'm washed years old. When I was young, you whippersnappers.
Yo, you weren't even out the womb yet.
Bruh, okay. by the time you were born, right? What was I doing? Like I knew, like mind you, I knew how to ride a bike when you were born. Like put it like that.
Yeah,
when you were born, I knew how to keep the change from the errand my mom sent me on. Because you had to get old enough to not. Because when you get back home, you gotta switch the topic. Mom, did you hear that? And then she forget you took the money. By the time you were born, I was.
When Becky got her Greek citizenship, I had already knew how to, like, you know, I already had the birds and the bees conversation.
Done. You are giving it to your nephew.
That's crazy. You guys are disrespectful. You know what?
No, but seriously.
Go to sleep. Since
Becky,
you're so
old. Becky, by the time you said your first words, I was coming back from school by myself.
Nobody had to walk you to the bus stop.
None.
Oh, man.
And I know. These are just how washed we are.
You mad young, my nigga. That's basically what we're trying to say.
All right, goodbye.
No, seriously.
Goodbye, this show is over.
If we come to your birthday dinner, we're going to be asking people how their parents are. So how's mommy and daddy doing?
How's your mom? How's your dad?
That's crazy.
It's okay.
You did it to yourself. You should have never showed us that video.
No, but it's a lifestyle. This is what the new age kids are doing.
New age kids.
Like back in our days, we were looking at regular sexual videos, blue film on TV screens that were like.
Blue film?
We're watching blue film, and that screen, we'd have to go to channel 100 or something, and the screen would be going up and down.
Remember, we had scramblers back then, dog?
Yes, bro. Like, we would have the volume on 2.
You guys are probably like.
You had to wait until after 11 o'clock till the nasties came on?
No, seriously. Like, we had to wait till the end. As soon as our parent come up, we'll turn the TV off and we would sit in the dark still.
Bravo. These young kids don't understand.
They don't know. They watching TV on their apps.
They don't understand the show.
They don't know. Like, they don't. And when you were talking about Pokemon, I was going to say how we had to worry about AA batteries. Like, everything is charged now.
Young kids don't understand the show.
I used to be addicted to Pokemon, and my mom didn't want me to, so I would go to the bathroom and play Pokemon. And every time she would walk by, I would flush the toilet.
This is so funny, dog.
So she knows that there's something happening and she wouldn't bother me. And then I would go to school the next day with red eyes where we talk about SmackDown and other stuff. Like, you don't know. They don't understand. Thursday was SmackDown. It was for SmackDown.
They could just go on their phones and type in Pornhub.com.
And that's it. Regular. Just
we had to wait until 11.
Enter somebody's Wi-Fi and just die. They were just watching
squiggly lines, dog.
Bro, they don't know. Like, we were watching Hector Sketch porn. Like, it didn't add up. It didn't add up. Like, we would see it. Like, you would hear a moan, and you weren't sure who it came.
You weren't sure if someone behind you or...
What's going on here? But you know...
was on two.
Bro, two. Like, two.
You just needed to hear if it was a whisper or static. You didn't know if it was different.
Off the TV. Like, as soon as somebody cracks the door open to go use the bathroom, TV off, and you're just sitting in this style. In the dark.
You're like, what are you watching? It was the news.
It was the news. Yeah, I heard something about Bill Clinton, and you know how he's a black person in my mouth. And like, these are things we did. But you wouldn't understand. You wouldn't understand.
All right, shut up.
You have an app, and your app has filters of different pornography you want to watch.
Those were special times. I feel like those years built character, dog.
This, you can't. Come on, bro. You
young
can't.
Kids don't have that now. They can everything. They have access to everything, so they don't understand
everything.
What it's like to have to sneak and like bro, watch they, crazy shit.
They will never understand, bro. How it didn't even matter the storyline for this porn, bro.
They never had to understand this. They don't. They never had to wait for the dial-up to happen.
Oh my God, you couldn't be online, and your mom expecting a phone call from back home, like. That's it from you. You just stop getting off this LOL chat room. No more age, sex, location for you.
Hey, yo, I had dial-up internet once upon a time, too.
Like, at what age?
Nah,
at what age?
Nah,
at what
age? That's because you were in Congo. Could use it? That's why.
First of all, I was never in Congo. I wasn't even
born. Did Greece have internet over there? Or were y'all bankrupt already?
No, this was before the bankruptcy.
It's funny how you keep claiming Greece for me when I ain't never claim it. Like, ever, yeah, ever.
You're mad,
I thought she grew up with...
Why are you lying?
She grew up with Antetokounmpo, I mean.
Antetokounmpo, yeah. She was with, Antetokounmpo for whatever he pronounced.
Yeah, he...
Antetokounmpo. How are you Yoruba? That's the ultimate scam, dog.
I don't like this double teaming. I don't like this.
Oh, no. There's nobody double teaming. No, take that back.
When you
the gang you've joined, you've started.
Yeah, when you decided to send a video of somebody putting their tongue between two double cheeks, that was the problem.
And I like to use the tongue double team again.
Please, yeah, that was really, that was very horrible. Trump is getting to you, and it bothers me.
Wow. All this time, you've been a Trump supporter.
She's a trumpeter.
She has joined gang.
She has joined alt-right.
No, she's so alt. She's not even alt right again. She's alt left.
Wow.
Goodbye.
No more Wahala. That is
the premise of the show. Wonderful. It all comes full circle.
Thank you to Mr. Obama. We all want to say thank you. We've enjoyed your 8 years.
Obama, thank you for being a legend. Thank you. I actually went to the inauguration. This time 8 years ago, I was in D.C.
Oh, yeah? See?
Yeah.
I was... I remember when he won. Like, I was running through Parkchester yelling. And people were telling me to go to bed. And I said, F you. So, shout out. I was too excited. And then I remember when Jeezy dropped My President is Black. I still get goosebumps. And I remember when Jay-Z did the remix.
I love that song.
Yo, it's so crazy. Like, yo, it felt like we were going to wake up and they were going to be like, ha. But, yo.
Just kidding.
Yeah, shout out to Barack. Shout out to the beautiful daughters of theirs. They were so grateful for 8 years. It was just, it was a movie we got to see, like, insane. And now we're back to reality show.
let's hope our next episode is actually even allowed to happen. Who knows what will happen in the next week,
bro? It's crazy when we think about the fact that we actually got to live through Obama, like the history books that our kids are gonna be reading. Like,
let's hope he stays in the history books.
Right. They're trying to erase the man. B. First with this ACA, are they taking Obama phones away? Cause the hood gonna cry.
That's all gone. Oh, that's
it's gone.
Damn, dang. He's the one that made all that happen.
Bro, he really did a lot for the people's view. Obamacare, Obama phones, there's just so much that is just regular in the hood. Obama fried chicken.
Oh, you're so stupid.
Obama fried chicken all over the place.
You're so stupid. free Wi-Fi for low income homes, too. Like,
bro.
Yeah, all that's gonna stop.
Oh, and F you to the MTA. They're making it $3 now. I'm sorry.
When does that happen?
It's happening very soon.
No, but listen, the single rides have been $3, though, for a minute.
No, they have not.
Yes, they have.
This is $7.5.
The single rides?
Yeah.
They've been jipping you, bro.
You're from Jersey, that's why. They don't
that's Jersey, a Jersey tax. I pay $2.75, but in New York, I pay $3.
Yeah, they know you're from Jersey.
They hit you with the Jersey tax.
You give them $3, and they're like, all right, here you go.
They're like, she's alt-left. We have to charge her more.
You know what? Goodbye, bro.
Nah, it's been $2.75. All seriousness, though.
It's been $3. I swear to you.
I'm telling you right now. It's
$2.75. Okay, I'll look you at guess your office tomorrow. Matter of fact, no, let's have a group meeting. 12 o'clock tomorrow. Let's meet at one subway station and click single ride. I promise you that shit is.
Why would I want you to get a tax on yourself for no reason? I know I'm not getting the tax.
The $3 you're paying, we appreciate you because it's better in New York City. But it's just
I really don't like the both of you. But
we know that because you sent us a video of people eating butt.
Why would you care of someone dining on Yash? Like, bro, why is this
questions, yo.
No, there's so much you have to explain. All before 21, like, Becky is a wild child, V.
Wild. That's a Jersey shit.
Speaking of wild, real quick before we leave, I need help deciding on what piercing I'm getting for this year.
Peace, guys. Thanks for tuning in. It's been a pleasure.
Shout out to all my co-hosts. Shout out to Becky. Shout out to Bawo. Yo, tune in to us. Tune in to the next episode. We're hopefully
Trump plantations.
Hopefully we're not on a plantation and we're actually able to
record. And if we are, we will get service and we will be,
shout out to passports.
Life on the plantation.
If you don't have your passport, please get one, you know, just in case, you never know.
I just want to say this, whatever Trump does, don't let him divide us, and don't share crop shame anybody that's into shit.
And don't tweet anything crazy that's going to get you in trouble. You don't.
Oh, my Lord. Happen. Don't say anything. Don't tweet nothing crazy. Like, in the words of Jay-Z, I live with this. It says, made men don't make statements. So just move alike. Let's keep it to yourself. If you think it might lead to something, just keep it to yourself.
Just act like your opponent. Just think it. You don't have to say it. Just think it. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Boom.
That's it.
Right. Before Becky says something else that she's making me hang up on her, this is a great episode. We will see you guys next week. Boom.